to the stream. So it turns out that some of my previous streaming, I was using OBS Studio and the sound wasn't working. There's no sound right now, so it's just me talking. But the sound wasn't working previously, so I switched back to regular OBS so we can see how this is going. So what you're seeing on the screen is a screen cap from one of the original Mass Effect Andromeda trailers. Mass Effect and BioWare have been dropping a lot of hints and stuff all of a sudden starting yesterday, along with a new quick trailer talking about Mass Effect Andromeda. And with N7 Day coming up on Monday, and with all that stuff, I figured it was time for me to chime in and get going with something that's probably one of my absolute favorite games of all times. I'm so excited for Mass Effect Andromeda. You can't really hear it in my voice right now because I'm just that excited. But trust me, this is like the greatest thing in the history of ever. So what I figured I would do is take you guys through another journey of the Mass Effect universe. We're going to go ahead and play through the entire Mass Effect trilogy, 1, 2, and 3, and we're going to start with 1 in just a second. But yeah, if you guys haven't already, you know, check out some of the stuff that they've been leaking for Mass Effect Andromeda, and we'll see you guys on Monday, November 7th, aka N7 Day, for the new trailer and the new stuff that they are planning on releasing. Until then, let's get started. There it is. Mass Effect, you are the greatest thing ever. I did install a mod. It's the MEIUM something. It's basically a high-res texture map mod for most of the characters and stuff, so it should look better than the original. And I'll put a link down in the description a little bit later when I remember. But until then, we're going to start a new career.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database. Classified information requested.
You can have it.
Establishing secure connection. Secure connection confirmed.
New ID.
Please log in to access your profile.
So the canon Shepard is female, and it doesn't look like my mod is working, but I'll fix that for next time. The official Shepard is the FemShep, so most of my playthroughs are FemSheps. Plus, and you know, the voice actress Jennifer Hale does an amazing job. Like, not to say that Mark Meer, you know, Dude Shep, doesn't do a great job. I think Jennifer Hale does a little bit better. So we're going to go with Patty Shepard.
Warning, data corruption detected.
Oh no, data corruption.
Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history.
Okay. The history just changes a little bit of the dialogue and whatever custom history mission that you have. And I realized that in all of my playthroughs, I've never actually chosen Spacer. Or if I have, I've never done the Spacer history mission. So I'm going to do that and try and show that here, because apparently there's a wonderful little like Easter egg for it.
Confirm psychological profile.
And then this, again, changes some of the dialogue for the psychological profile based on the, like some of the history of the service of our Shepard. But it also affects, like some of the starting stats for Paragon and Renegade points that you've already accrued, where Ruthless starts you with some extra Renegade points, War Hero starts you with some extra Paragon points, and Soul Survivor starts you with a little bit less total points, but a little bit in each. And I really enjoy dialogue options. And I'm probably going to be doing as balanced a playthrough as possible. You know, some Paragon, some Renegade. So I'm probably going to go with Soul Survivor here. I have most of my playthroughs that I've done in the past for myself have been mostly Paragon. The one Renegade that I tried, I didn't really enjoy it as much. I didn't like some of the dialogue and some of the acting that went along with it. It just didn't feel right to me. So, yes, there will be some Renegade options, but there are a few that I know to avoid, so we're going to go ahead and avoid that. But we're going to be the sole survivor of that thing.
Military specialization.
All right, so the class that we're going to go with, again, according to, official lore, soldier is the specialization, which is just straight up guns and combat. It's your standard, Battlefield, Call of Duty, whatever thing. I've done it. It was honestly one of the, probably the second most boring playthrough I've done. The soldier's pretty, they get access to the most weapons. They get access to some of the heaviest armor. It's just not as flashy and cool. The engineer that I did, it was all right. It was very support heavy. And like I said, it was all right. It's a lot weaker in Mass Effect 1 than in some of the later ones, where you actually get drone and some, and they redo some of the powers and stuff. But again, it was all right. It was pretty good. Infiltrator, you're a sniper, so it takes some of the combat abilities from the soldier and from the engineer and mixes them together. This is probably the, in some instances, this was the most boring, just because, you're a sniper, you're hanging out, you're taking long pod shots on things. And that was really, really boring in my opinion, except when you're in close quarters and you don't really have the ability to snipe. And then it's like, well, now I got to rely on my teammates, my AI teammates for stuff. So it was, Sentinel is a combination of the Adept, which I skipped for a reason, and the Engineer. And in Mass Effect 1, it takes probably the weakest, worst bits of both of those and puts them together into the Sentinel. In the Mass Effect 2 and 3, they completely gutted and revamped the Sentinel classes and made it something different. That's probably my least favorite class in the later ones. Vanguard, takes the Adept and the Soldier, and is actually probably one of the most fun ones that I had. It was the very first one I ever chose, was Vanguard, and it was hella fun. But my absolute favorite was always the Adept. Just, to quote or, take an idea from other, space opera video games, it's a space wizard. And it's especially in 2 and 3, in the later times, you get ridiculously overpowered. And I love it. So I'm going to go with the Adept. Now you may be saying, hey, I thought you played through this a lot. You said you played through this a lot. Yes. All of my playthroughs, except for one, have been on my 360 back when I played that. The only one I've done through on here was the Soldier class. And it was pretty boring. So, because we did that, we get a free assault rifle. Identification. I don't like her default hair, so I always change her hair style. Come on. Turn your head. Go back. Why isn't the head turning? Click and drag with the right mouse. Aha! There we go. I can read. I really can. Come on. What's the hair that I like? Where is it? I mean, for you know, somebody that's military, you know, with their hair would probably be up in a bun. I think that's the one that. Yeah, that's fine. And then everything else, I just keep the same.
Profile reconstruction complete.
And that's what we're going with. It's Patty Shepard, who was born a spacer on a ship. She was a sole survivor of her crew. She is an adept, very powerful, you know, biotic warrior. And she is, you know, being a soldier, trained with assault rifles. So now, once you confirm, you want to be unable to change any settings until we get to the next game. But this is what we're going with.
Identification confirmed.
Yep. That's all the same.
Well, what about Shepard? She's a spacer, lived aboard starships most of her life.
Military service runs in the family. Both her parents were in the Navy.
She saw her whole unit die on a cruise. She could have some serious emotional scars.
Every soldier has scars. Shepard's a survivor.
Is that the kind of person we want protecting the galaxy?
That's the only kind of person who can protect the galaxy.
I'll make the call.
In the year 2148, explorers on Mars discovered the remains of an ancient spacefaring civilization. In the decades that followed, these mysterious artifacts revealed startling new technologies enabling travel to the furthest stars. The basis for this incredible technology was a force that controlled the very fabric of space and time. They called it the greatest discovery in human history. Civilizations of the galaxy called it the Mass Effect. Oh, that sounds just giving me the shivers. Beautiful space. And Normandy, my second home.
Arcturus Prime relays in range. Initiating transmission sequence.
Commander?
Oh, Jenkins. I miss you so much, buddy.
We are connected. Calculating transit mass and destination. The relay is hot. Acquiring approach vector. All stations secure for transit. Screen. Approach run has begun. Hitting the relay in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, the goosebumps.
Thrusters. Check. Navigation. Check. Internal emission sync engaged. All systems online. Drift. Just under 1500K.
1500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
That's enough. Your soldiers act like it.
Sorry, Commander.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant.
Ooh.
Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
I'm on my way.
Is it me or does the captain always sound a little pissed off?
Only when he's talking to you, Joker.
Oh, Joker. And Caden. Oh, you boys. Oh, so that's another thing. No, I'll save it for later.
I'm telling you, I just saw him. He marched by like he was on a mission.
He's a Spectre. They're always on a mission.
And we're getting dragged right along with him.
Relax, Presley. You're going to give yourself an ulcer.
Yeah, Presley. Why don't you relax?
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down in engineering. I didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
You think the Alliance brass is holding out on us?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihlus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
You don't trust Nihlus.
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War. Lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
That was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihlus for that.
No, I guess not. But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board. Especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihlus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command. And they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihlus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, ma'am. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated Special Forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihlus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good.
Oh, yeah, the dialogue.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not the kind of place Spectres visit. There's something Nihlus isn't telling us about this mission.
That's crazy. The captain's in charge here. He wouldn't take orders from a Spectre.
Not his choice, Doc. Spectres don't answer to anyone. They can do whatever they want. Kill anyone who gets in their way.
Oh, you watch too many spy vids, Jenkins.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some...
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
Only a fool goes looking for a...
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Do your job, follow my orders, and there won't be any problems.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself on a coups. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
This mission isn't about personal glory, Corporal. We have a job to do. Don't do anything stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, ma'am. I'm not going to screw this up.
The captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander.
So much dialogue. I love exploring all the dialogue options. They paint such an amazing picture.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
The captain said he'd meet me here.
He's on his way. I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
I've never been there.
But you know of it. It's become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why didn't we keep the beacon for ourselves?
You humans don't have the best reputation. Some species see you as selfish, too unpredictable, too independent, even dangerous.
Sharing that beacon will improve relations with the Council. Plus, we need their scientific expertise. They know more about the Protheans than we do.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
What's going on?
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
Not many could have survived what you went through on Akuz. You showed a remarkable will to live, a particularly useful talent. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Get down! attack, taking heavy casualties. I repeat, heavy casualties. We can't... An evac! They came out of nowhere. We need...
Everything cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5. Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Thus begins the journey of the Shepard.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, you're coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihilus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
I don't like putting my life in the hands of a Turian, sir.
Nihilus is on our side. He wants you in the Spectres, and he wants that beacon.
Ready and able, sir.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
You'll need it.
We are approaching drop point two.
Ship perimeter secured, Commander.
This place got hit hard, Commander. Hostiles everywhere. Keep your guard up.
Assault rifle on. That's right, you. That. You doesn't matter. Alright, what do we got? Throw. Warp. Oh, little explodey things. Bet we got training with assault rifles. It's horrendous. I guess we'll go back to our pistol. Much better. Yep, still a box over here. Take all. It's good to see Mass Effect again. Okay. That was just that way, so now we can go back this way towards the big beacony thing. Think? Maybe? No. Fuck, it's been so long. This way. What's this way? I just took a wrong turn. There it is. There's the turn.
Oh god. What happened here?
Oh no, Jenkins.
Right through his shields. Never had a chance.
Sometimes Marines die. The rest of us just have to carry on. We still have to find that beacon.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Poor Jenkins. Oof, what's with this freezing?
I've got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. A lot of bodies. I'm gonna check it out. I'll try to catch up with you at the dig site.
Forget, there's no reloading. I just wasted a grenade.
Perimeter clear.
Oh. Oof. The way to go. I suppose we should help Ash.
Commander, I didn't think I was gonna make it. Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, ma'am?
Give me a status report, Williams.
Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, ma'am. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
Good question.
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, ma'am. It's time for payback.
Describe what happened leading up to the attack.
We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol, until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
I don't know. They set up camp near the beacon. The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
Tell me everything you know about the beacon.
They were doing some digging out here to extend the monorail and expand the colony. A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins, and suddenly every scientific expert in the colony was interested. That's when they brought us in to secure the site. I don't know much about the beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Veil. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Have you seen a Turian Spectre around here?
There aren't any Turians on Eden Prime, none that I've ever met. Not sure I'd be able to tell if one was a Spectre anyway.
If you saw this guy, you'd know. Carries enough firepower to wipe out a whole platoon. Luckily, he's on our side.
Sorry. Like I said, no Turians.
Move out!
Alright. Equipment. Excuse me. Yes, I'll take that. Give Ashley the high caliber barrel. There we go. All right. Just max out our charm and intimidate so we can get some dialogue options going. Caden. Some defense. Some decryption. Some extra first aid. That's good. Ashley, you get the assault rifle. Gunner. Come on. There you go. And this gives us adrenaline bursts, a shield boosts. There you go. Right.
The beacon's at the far end of this trench.
Hey, we picked up some new stuff. Of course. I put the thing in the wrong thing. Empty. We're using hand cannons. Yes. Take that. Give us. Guess we didn't take that out. Armor piercing. Caden. Ashley uses assault rifles. That's kind of garbage. Nothing extra. Okay, fine. Sure. Yep, Ashley's using the assault rifle. He's still using that. Great. Alright, sorry about that. Should get another attack here in a moment. Maybe not. Just warp him. Can we not even see him? Duck over here. No, I said duck. There we go. Huh?
Negative contacts, Commander.
Good. Take all this shit.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Stop putting your weapon in a way. This is inactive.
Plan, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
Copy that, Nihilus. We are on our way.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up. Oh, God. They're still alive.
Well,
what did
sort
they
of.
Do to them?
God, fucking die. Oh, we overheated. Just throw him down. And he's dead. Cool.
Perimeter clear.
Alright. Huh? Come on. All right, there you go. Put our weapons away, it'd be easier. All right, this one's open. And this one has some people to talk to.
Door, it's closed. Security locks engaged.
Humans, thank.
Hurry, close the door before they come back.
How did you end up in this shed?
We hid here during the attack. They must have come here for the beacon. Luckily, it wasn't here. It was moved to the spaceport earlier this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment. The next, we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the Destroyers, bringers of darkness, heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside, gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart of evil. Awakened the beast. Unleashed the darkness.
Manuel, please. This isn't the time.
Did you notice a Turian in the area?
I saw him. The Prophet. Leader of the enemy. He was here before the attack.
That's impossible. Nihlus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry. Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in.
I can give him some medication. Alright, I got nothing here. Alright, let's go. Gotta get to the spaceport.
Saren. Nihlus.
This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
Well, that was a shot.
What is that? Off in the distance.
It's a ship. Look at the size of it.
Hey, Sovereign. See each other again later. That I promise. Husks. Got them all. Okay. heal up. This is probably like the weakest thing about this game. Is a weird decryption
Everybody
thing.
Everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out. We're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
Nobody moves a muscle until we know who you are.
Nice going, Cole. I told you we should have stayed hidden.
It's okay. We're all on the same side here. We're just farmers. We've been hiding ever since that ship first showed up.
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only, it was coming from inside your own head.
It was probably trying to block communications.
Whatever it was, felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to think.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
If there's something you're not telling me...
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
What kind of packages?
I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
The Paragon Renegade options.
I'm only gonna ask this once. Think long and hard before you lie to me again. Are you sure all you've got is one lousy pistol?
Wait, I just remembered. I just had it in my pocket. You might as well take that too. That's everything, really.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
Would you rather be a snitch or a corpse?
Powell. His name's Powell.
No honor among thieves.
That's all I know, really. So let's try to keep things friendly from here on in, okay?
I have to go.
Good luck.
I have to go. What else you got hiding back here? Oh. Who has electronics? Caden? Oh, we can open up some electronics. Yeah. Alright. Go through. Ugh. Alright, fine. Shield boost, yay, so that we can eventually get pistols. I just want to be able to get pistols to get just a little bit in there first before we start going into throw and lift, warp, singularity. Oh, barrier? I only need 1 point? Okay. Do some barrier, and then we'll go basic armor. Your shield boost, and we're good. Equipment. Pistol. I will take that. Here we go. Yeah, this weird little game thing. And some Krogan armor that we won't use for a while. Probably end up selling it first. That's probably one of the two biggest downfalls of this game was the decryption, hacking, whatever mechanic they had, and then the Mako, which we'll see later.
Commander, it's Nihlus.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait, don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
What are you doing sneaking around back there?
I'm sorry, I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
What the hell are you talking about?
There were two Turians here, your friend and another one he called Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
You're Cole's contact here on the docks for the smuggling ring.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the Geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing from the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch! We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who'd want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Just give me the grenades.
They're yours. Take them. My smuggling days are over, I swear.
Too many people died here for you to start jerking.
Okay, all right. There was something else. Could be worth a fortune. Experimental technology, top of the line. Take it. I don't need it. I didn't want anyone to get hurt. Really, I'm sorry.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
You were sleeping? I thought you were working here on the docks.
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
You ditch work, then you cower back here and do nothing while the Geth butcher everyone else.
I don't even have a gun. What was I supposed to do, run out there and die? I couldn't save them. Nobody could. It was horrible.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. One minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
Is there anything else you can tell me about?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago. Feels like a whole other life.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Hey. Can upgrade our grenades. Maybe. Oh, better. Even upgrades for that stim pack. Ashley can have shield battery. Hey, medkit. Upgrade kit in the fire. Thank you. We have Barry now. Go on my part. Shoot forward a little bit. Hang on, Caden. Oop, apparently we need to hold on too. So glad they fixed the cover mechanic in the next game. It's kind of trash in this one.
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Checking, make sure everybody
demolition charges
keeps their weapon. That was a weird bug that got it. The weird bug that sometimes when moving between areas getting parked at storm across this one, they can handle that stuff. But there's a weird bug that sometimes when putting weapons away and switching between areas, your teammates will switch to the wrong weapons. Give them a grade. That I don't think did much of anything. Literally do not have time for this. We'll have to metagel in a second. Hold on, boys. Oh, we had a sniper. There is another one. A, maybe? No. Come on. We got plenty of time. 3.5 minutes. Oh, there's another bomb there. Oh, and that's the sound of... Oh, all charges disarmed. Some more stuff outside here. Storage locker, yep. You know, I almost prefer the memory game of the console. So when you're like decrypting or hacking anything on any of the consoles, you have this little like game of memory, like Simon says, where it's like, you know, you push one button, it shows you, it blinks a light, and you push the same button, it does the same thing. As opposed to this one, which is like, hey, line some stuff up and then shoot through the bars. I believe there's one more on the other side, and then we can click the beacon right there. Yeah, I was wrong. Okay. Back to the beacon.
Normandy. The beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
Wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up.
Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Go.
Shepard!
No, don't touch her. It's too dangerous.
Normandy, where's my evac?
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
Dr. Chakwas, I think she's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Like the morning after shore leave. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
I expect better of you, Lieutenant. You endangered the entire mission.
Don't be so hard on him, Commander. We have no idea if that's what actually set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction. Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our exo holding up, Doctor?
Well, and all the readings look normal. I'd say the commander's going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
The Geth would have wiped out the whole colony if I hadn't stopped them.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best, a living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous, and he hates humans.
He especially hates you, but that's a story for another time.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how. I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we going to tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the Council will revoke his specter status.
I'll contact the Ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'm back here yet.
Glad to see you're okay, Commander.
Commander, I'm glad to see you're okay. Losing Jenkins was hard on the crew, and I'm glad we didn't lose you, too.
Things were pretty rough down there.
Yeah, you never get used to seeing dead civilians. It doesn't seem right somehow. But at least you stopped Saren from wiping out the whole colony.
I couldn't have done it without you.
We're Marines. We stick together. And I'm just sorry that we lost Jenkins.
Yeah, I wish I could have done something to save him.
I was there. You did everything right. It was just bad luck.
It's been a hell of a shakedown, Cruz. Our first mission ends with one Spectre killing another. The Citadel Council's not going to be happy about that. Probably use it to lever more concessions out of the Alliance.
You've got a good grasp of the situation. You a career man?
Yeah, a lot of biotics are. We're not restricted, but we sure don't go undocumented. May as well get a paycheck for it. Besides, my father served. I made him proud when I enlisted. Eventually.
But is that why you're here? Because of your family?
I was a regular Navy brat. I got a little more noteworthy than the folks expected.
Oh, that's right, a coups. I imagine that bought you any post in the fleet.
Word is we're heading for the Citadel, ma'am. Can you, tell me why?
Captain hopes the ambassador can get an audience with the Council. Tell them what Saren's...
Makes sense. They'd probably like to know he's not working for them anymore. Whatever happens, we'll be ready, Commander.
Yes, Commander? Is there some...
How well do you know the Lieutenant?
I'd never worked with him before this mission. But he has an impressive service record. Over a dozen special commendations. Tends to keep to himself, though. Maybe because of the headaches. It's not easy being an L2.
What does that have to do with it?
Well, most biotics now use the L3 implants. Lieutenant Alenko was wired with the old L2 configuration. Sometimes there are complications.
What kind of complications?
Severe mental disabilities, insanity, crippling physical pain. There's a long list of horrific side effects. Caden's lucky. He just gets...
What do you know about Captain Anderson?
I've served with him for a few tours now. He knows when to let things slide and when to crack the whip. The crew knows he's seen pretty much anything they'll ever run into. And he cares about the people under his command.
How did you end up serving on an Alliance ship?
I enlisted right out of med school. Earth always seemed boring to me. Too safe, too secure. I figured the colonies were teeming with exotic adventure. I wanted to travel the stars, tending the wounds of tough soldiers with piercing eyes and sensitive souls. Turns out military life isn't quite as romantic as I'd imagined. But humanity needs the Alliance if we want to keep expanding through the Traverse. And the Alliance always needs good doctors. So I stayed on to do my part.
Ever think you made the wrong choice?
Sometimes I think about opening a private practice back on Earth. Or maybe taking a position at one of the new med centers out in the colonies. But there's something special about working on soldiers. If I left the Alliance now, I'd feel like I was abandoning them.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
I should go. Hey, Ash.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Thanks, Commander. I appreciate that.
Things were pretty rough down there. Are you okay?
I've seen friends die before. Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit wiped out. And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't have shown up.
We couldn't have done it without you, Williams.
Thanks, Commander. I have to admit, I was a little worried about being assigned to the Normandy. It's nice when someone makes you feel welcome.
I think you're gonna fit in here just fine, Williams.
Thanks, Commander.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. Losing Jenkins was hard enough.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work.
Look at the size of that ship.
The Ascension.
flagship of the Citadel fleet.
Well, size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower, too.
The Ascension's got it.
Monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower. Normandy out.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
I will never get tired of watching this ship dock.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of a Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Bastards.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. If they don't stop him, I will.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not hers.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
All right. Just sneak this little console here. Alliance Patrol Report. Captain Hendrickson reported some unusual energy readings during patrol of the Argos Row cluster. She had particular concerns about the Hydra system, but was recalled before her team could investigate further. No patrols are scheduled for that sector. Do we want to send in a recon team? So that gave us a side mission thing that we can go do. Over there is the Elcor/Volus embassy. Down here. We have the embassy receptionist.
To the Presidium, allow me to be your guide.
Avena. There's a bar up here. Actually, we don't need to go there just yet.
Welcome to the Presidium.
Yes,
allow
thanks.
Me to be your guide.
Head right to the tower. Obsidian. Citadel Tower.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the Council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Who were you just talking to?
That was Executor Palin, head of Citadel Security, my boss. He'll be presenting my findings on Saren to the Council.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. But he's a Spectre. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
You later, Karis.
You don't want to keep the Council waiting.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard, the one who let the beacon get destroyed.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihlus gone, his files passed on to me. I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Well, you're mostly right there, Captain.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like, and he has to be stopped.
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial district. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Barla Vaughn's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
Killing innocents doesn't end wars. It causes them.
I know how the world works, Commander. Sometimes you're forced to make unpleasant decisions. But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Our ambassador doesn't seem to get along with the Council.
He's just frustrated. The Council's always preaching that we need to be part of the galactic community. But for them, it's a one-way street. They want us to expand and settle unstable regions like the Skillian Verge and the Attican Traverse. But when we run into trouble, they don't want to help us out. Everyone knows it's only a matter of time until we get a seat on the Council. The Ambassador just thinks it should happen sooner rather than later. And I agree.
Maybe they'd let us join the Council if we were more willing to cooperate with the other species.
Of course they would. If we did everything they told us to, they'd love to have us on the Council. But it wouldn't be much of a deal for us. I understand their side. They don't want us dominating the Council. It's founded on cooperation and alliances. But we have to look out for our own interests, too.
I want to know more about the Spectres.
They're not your typical government agency. They tend to work alone, behind the scenes. They take care of problems that come. It's not easy preserving peace across an entire galaxy. The Council prefers to use diplomacy and negotiation. But sometimes more extreme measures are needed.
What happens when a Spectre goes rogue, like Saren?
It doesn't happen often. The Council is careful when they select their candidates. But when something does go wrong, there's usually only one solution. Send another Spectre to bring the rogue agent down.
They sound like shadow operatives.
Everything about them is classified. We don't even know how many there are. The latest Alliance estimate puts their numbers under 100. But the Council couldn't do its job without them. They're the Citadel's top agents, the last line of defense, the final option before open war. The entire galaxy respects and fears them. If a Spectre shows up, you know something big is about to happen.
What's their command structure like?
There is no command structure. Each Spectre answers directly to the Council. Sometimes they're sent on specific missions. Other times, they act on their own. They tend to operate outside the law, do whatever it takes to accomplish their goals. The Council just turns a blind eye. Spectres have a lot of power, Shepard.
How do they decide who becomes a Spectre?
You can't just apply to join. There's no training program. Spectres aren't made. They're born. The Council's always looking for exceptional individuals. People who can get the job done, like you. They've been watching you for years. They see something in you. They want you on their side. Nihlus was supposed to give them a final recommendation, but with him gone, things are still up in the air.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
He's a necessary evil of galactic politics. Buying and selling information is a part of the game, and the Shadow Broker just happens to be the best player on the field. Always sells to the highest bidder. Doesn't get involved in politics, doesn't pick sides. A simple system, but it works. He's not a threat to anyone, not directly. He's just a resource we can use, or she is, or maybe they are. Nobody really knows.
Tell me about Barla Vaughn.
He specializes in moving large sums of money without leaving a paper trail. A financial genius, doesn't do anything illegal, but he knows all the loopholes. He's got an impressive client list. Ambassadors, diplomats, specters. That's probably why the Shadow Broker uses him.
You don't think much of Harkin.
The guy joined CSEC about 20 years ago. He's been an embarrassment to our species ever since. Roughing up suspects in custody, bribery accusations, alcohol and drug use. The embassy used to step in when he got in trouble. But I guess enough was enough.
I thought this embassy was supposed to help humans.
Harkin may be human, but he's also an ass. He's had more than his share of chances. If the embassy wasn't protecting him, he would have been fired 15 years ago. CSEC is better off without him.
Guy's a scumbag. He should have been cut loose a long time ago.
He was one of the first human CSEC officers. Guess it would have looked bad if he got fired. A lot of backroom deals were worked out over the years to keep him on the force. Politics is a dirty business sometimes, but it looks like his time's run out. We've got enough humans in CSEC now to stop protecting him.
I should go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the ambassador's office if you need anything else.
So Anderson talks about some of his history with Saren, which is actually covered in some of the books, which they're pretty good reads.
Bet all these staircases aren't just for show. They make for good defensive positions if this place is ever attacked.
That's a nice call there, Ash. We'll have to keep that in mind later. So the books. First three are written by Drew Karpyshyn. They're actually pretty good reads. They're not like the best reads, but they're pretty good.
That guy's up to something.
And I highly recommend reading them if you want to get know more about Anderson and some of his history. He's a pretty cool guy.
What? Oh, no, I wasn't. Never mind. Yes, is there something you want?
Why are you so interested in the Keepers?
Keepers? I've got no interest in the Keep...
Don't get coy. I know what I saw.
I'm not so sure I should be talking to you about this.
We're just talking. Is there something wrong with that?
No. I guess it wouldn't hurt to tell you. I'm using a small scanner to gather readings on the Keepers. So far I've had mixed results. I find it difficult to get near the creatures.
Why were you being so secretive about it, though?
Well, technically we're not supposed to disturb the Keepers. I don't really think my scanning disturbs them, but the authorities might disagree. I'd like to do it more openly, but it's not really worth getting arrested over.
I can help you out. I'm not worried about the authorities.
I don't even know who you are.
I'm Commander Shepard with the Alliance Military.
Well, I suppose I could use the help. You'll need this. It's the scanning device I developed. Activate it each time you see a Keeper. All collected data will automatically upload to my database. I'll even send a few credits your way for each unique scan.
What are you doing with the data once you've scanned it?
Trying to learn whatever I can about the Keepers. We see them working everywhere, yet we know so little about them. I'm a scientist. I want to know what makes them tick.
I should get going then.
Yes, I have much work myself. So long, and good luck with the scanning.
So now we can scan Keepers. We get a little bit of coin, a little bit of XP.
No, I'm waiting to speak with one of the counselor's assistants.
And then a big boost once we scan all of them on the Citadel, of which I think there's 12. And then we should get an Easter egg later, like I think Mass Effect 3. If we scan them all?
Be ridiculous. The Volus won't be joining the count.
I'm not so sure. The humans are making a strong push, and you can bet the Volus will be right on their coattails if they succeed.
I mean, it's not much, but every little bit helps, especially in the early game. And I think there's a third one somewhere around here. We'll find it later. We'll be back here enough times. Okay, so we have to go find Garrus. To do that, we gotta go find Harkin. We could also go talk to Bar Levon. and we're freezing for some reason. There we go. Oh, we're waiting on the elevator.
Can't believe the council ignored all the evidence against Saren.
Saren's one of their best operatives. It's only natural they take his word over ours.
Oh, so now we just chase leads while this smug Turian runs around with his Geth troopers.
That's politics, Chief.
I hate politics.
I also love all these elevator rides. You can pick up some side missions from them as well. You get little conversations between all the people you bring in. Pick up side missions, like I said, due to like news reports and stuff. It's all really cool.
Look at that bug thing over there. What's it doing?
Please do not disturb the keepers.
Another one.
Welcome to the Presidium. Allow me to be your guide.
So Vina's a VI. She tells you about stuff that's around here. I'd like to go this way real quick. Check out this cool little thing here. Yes, Ashley?
You know, art doesn't normally do much for me, but that relay statue?
Statue of a Mass Effect relay. Looks extremely lifelike. You know, like it could potentially function. So, I believe Bar Lafon is over here. This little building. Yep. What's up, Vaughn?
What's this? One of the Earth Clan. Ah, a very famous one, yes? You are the one called Shepard. The tale of how you survived the great tragedy on Akuz is truly remarkable. I am amazed each time I hear it.
I don't like strangers keeping tabs on me.
Forgive me, Earth Clan. My name is Bar Lafon. My job makes it necessary for me to keep informed. I am a financial advisor to many important clients here on the Citadel. When someone as important as yourself arrives on the station, I take notice.
I heard you work for the Shadow Broker. Do you have any information about Saren?
You're very blunt, Shepard. But you're right. I am an agent for the Shadow Broker. And I do know something about Saren.
I need that information. Now.
Threats don't work on me, Commander. This information is worth a small fortune. But this is an unusual situation, so I am going to let you have it for free.
What's the catch?
There is no catch. The Shadow Broker is quite upset with Saren right now. They used to do a lot of business, until Saren turned on him.
Saren betrayed him. Imagine that.
No matter what you think of Saren, he's not stupid. He knows the Shadow Broker is a valuable ally. Turning on him doesn't make sense. Not unless something huge was at stake. I don't know the details, but the Shadow Broker hired a freelancer to deal with it. A Krogan mercenary.
That's not much to go on.
I just told you that the most famous Spectre in the galaxy betrayed the Shadow Broker. Quite a bargain, considering the price. Speak with the Krogan if you want to learn more. I heard he was paying a visit to Citadel Security. If you hurry, you might catch him before he leaves the Academy.
Isn't it strange that a Krogan would want to speak with C-Sec?
Very. However, I doubt the visit was entirely his choice. You'll need to speak with him if you want to know more.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
Most people think I deal in finances, but my real currency is knowledge. I trade information, and it has made me very wealthy. But the Shadow Broker is the true master. Every day he buys and sells secrets that could topple governments, always giving them to the highest bidder. Yet somehow he never seems to upset the natural balance of power, All those secrets being passed around seem to even out. Nobody ends up with an advantage in the end.
Any guess what his identity might be?
I don't know. Nobody does. A shadow broker could be any race, any gender. I have a theory that it's actually an entire group working under one identity. How else could they juggle so many contacts at the same time? How else could they keep all that information from getting crossed? But they've got the perfect setup. Every government is forced to play their game so they don't get behind. But no matter how long you play, no matter how many secrets you buy, you can never win.
I thought you'd know more about the man you work for.
From time to time, I come across information I sell to the Shadow Broker. That's my only involvement. I like it that way. The more you know, the more dangerous the game becomes. I don't like danger, Commander. I'll leave that to you.
What's it like living here on the Citadel?
The station is, without a doubt, the greatest wonder in the galaxy. It is a technological marvel, but its true splendor goes much deeper than the hull and engines. From the Presidium to the wards, the entire station is a testament to the success of the Council. All the species of Citadel spaced together in a single, strong community.
What makes the Presidium so special?
It is the political center of Citadel space. 80% of all intelligent species in the known galaxy acknowledge the Council's authority on interstellar matters. But only the most powerful and influential species have embassies here on the Presidium. This level of the station is reserved for the elite, Shepard. People like us.
What are the wards like?
The cultural heart of the galaxy. They pulse with the lifeblood of millions of citizens from dozens of different species. You never know what you'll find down in the wards, Commander. It's always full of surprises. Fortunately, most of them are pleasant.
Tell me more about your job.
Galactic finance is incredibly complex. A mix of laws and regulations from dozens of interstellar economies. I'm an expert in how all these economies interact. For a fee, I share my expertise. I also offer premium services for those clients who need someone to conduct business without drawing unwanted attention. Discreet and efficient. That's my motto.
Sounds pretty shady.
Everything I do falls completely within the bounds of interstellar commerce law. Even so, many of my clients would prefer their transactions remain undisclosed. For example, suppose a Hanar ambassador was petitioning the Council to reduce tariffs on Hanar goods. How would it look if he had money invested in a Hanar exporting company? Even if his true motives were to help his people, he would be accused of advancing the petition for his own personal gain. I can keep his personal finances private.
Still sounds shady to me.
Then we can only hope you will never be cursed with a large enough fortune to require my services.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Slimy little ball. Speaking of the Hanar.
Ah, human. This one is greatly pleased to see you here in my decadent emporium.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder, though many in this place simply refer to it as Delan. Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase, all of great worth.
Why do you refer to yourself as this one and it?
For the same reason that humans are so inquisitive. It is part of our culture. Specifically, Hanar only refer to themselves in the first person with family or intimates. And we rarely do so with other species. It is just our way.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder, though many in this place simply refer to it as Delan. Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase, all of great worth.
What exactly do you sell?
Only the finest and most luxurious items that credits can buy. This one is able to procure almost any item the human would desire. For a price, naturally.
I think I should be going.
Return soon. This one receives new shipments regularly.
I love the hand art. They're kind of cute. Hey, there's a keeper over here. Then I think we might find our way down to the wards. Talk to, what's his name? Harkin. Oh, there's one right here.
I've had my office rearranged 5 times now.
5 times? But why? What do they want?
How should I know? It's not like keepers offer an explanation for what they're doing.
And yet, everyone just lets them go on doing whatever it is they do.
What choice do we have? If you try to stop them, they just shut down and another one replaces it.
Just strange that we know so little about them.
Not to mention frustrating.
I love all the little side conversations that are around. There. Let's travel. Words? Where is Dead? Then we're going to go this way. Then.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous shop. You want many good supplies, yes?
Goodbye.
Oh.
Yes, all right then. Good tidings to you, human.
Thank you, Morlin. I want to head up here and see a good friend of ours.
Is that really... Wow! It's you! You're Commander Shepard, the hero of Eden Prime. I am so honored to meet you.
Do I know you?
No, I'm just a fan. One of your biggest fans, actually. My name is Conrad. Conrad Werner. They say you killed more than 100 Geth on Eden Prime.
I spent most of my time trying to stay alive and help the colonists.
Hey, I know you're probably busy, but do you have time for a quick autograph?
Here you go.
Thanks. I really appreciate it. My wife is going to be so impressed. I'll let you get back to work. Oh, but next time you're on Earth, I'd love to buy you a drink. Thanks again!
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking Conrad Werner is some sort of creepy guy. But he's really just kind of a lovable little fan of ours. Oh, doors.
That's her.
Shit. And due to some lag, we just got a shotgun to the face. Shit. Totally forgot about saving stuff. We gotta go talk to Conrad again. My quick save buttons. Settings. Controls. Do quick save. F6. Got it.
Is that really... You're Commander Shepard, the hero of Eden.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Conrad. Conrad Ver...
I spent most
hey,
of my time...
I know you're probably busy, but I'll let you get back to work.
Uh, Actually, while I'm thinking about it, we'll go with that. Do a quick save.
That's her.
I see why this place is so popular. It's got quite the, view.
Hey, Lieutenant, put your tongue back in your mouth before you trip on it.
Hey, Harkin.
Hey there, sweetheart. You looking for some fun? Cause I gotta say, that soldier getup looks real good on that body of yours.
You're asleep.
Why don't you sit your sweet little ass down beside old Harkin? Have a drink. We'll see where this goes.
I'd rather drink a cup of acid after chewing on a razor blade.
You trying to hurt my feelings? You gotta do better than that. After 20 years with CSEC, I've been called every name in the book, Princess.
Call me Princess again and you'll be picking your teeth up off the floor. Now tell me where Garrus is.
Okay, just relax. Garrus, you say? You must be one of Anderson's crew. Poor bastard still trying to bring Saren down, huh? I know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Is there something I should know about the captain?
The captain used to be a Spectre. Didn't know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush. The first human ever given that honor, and then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
Well, he's not lying. Read the books, you'll find out.
Why'd they kick him out?
Have to ask him. I never heard any of the details. Bet it's a good story, though. The heroes fall. Classic tragedy.
You said they covered all this up. How'd you hear about it?
I spent 20 years working cases here on the Citadel. People on this station love to talk. Secrets are like herpes. If you got them, you might as well spread them around.
One more chance. Tell me where Garrus is, now.
Okay, settle down. He went to speak to Dr. Michelle, over in the med clinic on the other side of the wards.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, good. Go. Let me drink in peace.
Bastard. Glad you pulled a gun on him there.
Tell us he used to be a Spectre.
Kaplan's an ass. Bet he's just messing with our heads.
You're probably right.
Ward's locations. The med clinic. Hey, there's a keeper. Him real quick.
I didn't tell anyone, I swear!
That was smart, Doc. Now if Garrus comes around, you stay smart. Keep your mouth shut or we'll... Who are you?
Let her go.
You boys look to be in a spot of trouble. Got him.
Negative contacts, Commander.
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
You took him down clean.
Sometimes you get lucky. Dr. Michelle, are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Thanks to you, all of you.
Why were they threatening you? Who do they work for?
They work for Feast. They wanted to shut me up, keep me from telling Garrus about the Quarian.
What Quarian?
A few days ago, a Quarian came by my office. She'd been shot, but she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run. She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information in exchange for a safe place to hide.
Where is she now?
I put her in contact with Fist. He's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
Not anymore. Now he works for Saren. And the Shadow Broker isn't too happy about it.
Feast betrayed the Shadow Broker? That's stupid, even for him. Saren must have made him quite the offer.
That Quarian must have something Saren wants. Something worth crossing the Shadow Broker to get.
What else can you tell me about the Quarian?
I'm not sure. Like I said, she wanted to trade information for a place to hide. She didn't... Wait a minute. Geth. Her information had something to do with the Geth.
She must be able to link Saren to the Geth. There is no way the Council can ignore this.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
You're a Turian. Why do you want to bring him down?
I couldn't find the proof I needed in my investigation, but I knew what was really going on. Saren is a traitor to the Council and a disgrace to my people.
Welcome aboard, Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take him out.
Yeah, we heard about him.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
What's he doing there?
Fist accused him of making threats. We brought Rex in for a little talk. If you hurry, you can catch him at the academy before he leaves.
Move out.
All right, so now we have more squad members, so we can choose who we want to bring. And it shows you the strength and whatnot. So like if we bring in Ashley, she's got a ton of combat strength. Caden is split between biotic and tech. Garrus is tech and combat. I don't think it really matters, so we'll bring Garrus and we'll bring Caden along. And Ashley can go hang back at the ship. We need to level up Garrus. Good with an assault rifle. Attack armor. Some electronics. Get that late. Some of that. It's more first aid. Caden can pick up another electronics. Sentinel. I can pick pistol, make my shots better, and more warp. Okay, now let's go find us some wrecks. Which, I believe we could just walk there. Yeah, we should just be able to head on down.
Don't kid yourself. It's even bigger than it looks.
How would you know?
I got a tour. One of 500 to see the Ascension from the inside out.
Really?
Took almost 6 hours and we only saw 1/10 of the ship. I even got to meet the commander.
Matriarch LaDanya. You met her?
Well, she addressed everyone on the tour, but I got pretty close to her.
Huh, just look at that ship. You'd have to be stupid to mess with that.
Very true. She's got almost as much firepower as the rest of the Asari fleet combined.
Hopefully, she'll never need to use it.
I love all the side conversations. They give you such great, like, world and storytelling.
Hey, I know you. You're I saw the monument at Akuz. They got a whole section about you there. It's a miracle you survived.
Looks like you have a fan.
I'm sorry, I just never thought I'd meet someone like you in person. My name's Lang, Officer Eddie Lang, Citadel Security. It's an honor to meet you, Commander. What are you doing down here in the wards? Anything I can help you with?
Do you know a CSEC officer named Harkin?
I shouldn't really say too much. He's been on the force a lot longer than me. But I've heard things, you know? Drinking on the job, taking bribes, that kind of thing. Rumors mostly, but they suspended him, so some of it must be true.
What do you know about Spectres?
Just the stuff they show in the vids. They always make them out to be super agents on secret missions to save the galaxy. I know it's not really some of the other CSEC guys don't like them too much, figure they shouldn't be able to operate outside the law. But if they were so bad, the Council wouldn't use them, right?
How do you like working here on the Citadel?
This place is amazing. I've been here almost a year, and I still haven't seen a tenth of it. The Presidium's just so beautiful. Good place to go and relax. But I really like it here down in the wards. There's always something going on somewhere. Like that new club they just opened a few months ago, Flux. Wicked scene in there, Commander. You should check it out when you have some time.
Why'd you join Citadel Security?
I don't know. Seemed like the right thing to do, you know? Maybe it's in my blood. My grandfather was a cop back on Earth. It's kind of what CSEC is. Police for the Citadel. I'm still pretty new at it, but I like it so far. Way more interesting than staying back on Earth. You get to meet all kinds of cool aliens. Like those Hanar. Wild. Plus, CSEC gets a lot of respect here. We uphold the law. People, even aliens, appreciate that.
I have to go.
Right. You're probably real busy. Well, see you around, Commander.
Some more backstory and world building. I think that's part of why I love this game so much. You do such a great job, like, fleshing things out through, like, natural conversation or, like, overheard stuff or.
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
And that little news blurb was about our time on Eden Prime just recently. And some really bad, really quiet elevator. I don't know if you guys can hear it or not, but it's there. Rexy, old buddy, old pal.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Rex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
Go on. Get out of here.
I know you, human.
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you. We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying. Seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
I think we're gonna get along just fine, Rex.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
Alright, now we upgrade Rex. Assault rifles, yes please. We need to get you to shotguns. A shotgun boy. Got armor. You're done. Let's see what we can do about your shotgun. Scimitar. Have much there. Garrus. These. Guess we'll go with that for now. What's her name's not here? Okay, so now we can head down to Fist's Bar, which is back down here.
I'm surprised that you're willing to kill your own, Rex. Aren't the Krogan just a few generations away from
You don't get it. For all your talk of honor and pride, the Turians never had to test their principles in a real struggle. Anyone who fights us is either stupid or on Saren's payroll. Killing the latter is business. Killing the former is a favor to the universe.
Fist's Bar should be up over here somewhere, if I remember correctly. Oh, that's right, we have her.
Commander Shepard? Excuse me, Commander Shepard! I'm Emily Wong. I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't go. I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
You gotta have access to better sources. Why contact me?
I'm using every source I can find, but I think I've got a better shot with you. According to your file, you survived back on Akuz when everyone else in your squad got killed. If anyone can find the worst elements of the Citadel and live to tell about it, it's you.
How do you know that my investigation is going to uncover anything you need?
You wouldn't be investigating if it weren't big. And if it's big, it's something I'd like to hear about.
How do you know I'm investigating anything here on the Citadel?
I'm a good journalist, Commander Shepard. Word gets around.
Sounds like a good cause. If I find any information, it's yours.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
I better not. I won't. Find some stuff. Okay. That's Flux. Find Fist's place. Is it over here? It's been a while. I know it's. Maybe it is. For instance.
I know it was you. I remember your face.
Really? That's impressive. Usually you humans can't tell one Turian from another.
This was the place! Now, are you going to give me a refund or not?
Do you have your proof of purchase?
What? No, I don't think you ever gave me one.
I'm sorry, then. I can't help you.
But what do you...
Can't help you.
Net keeper.
Best place on this ward to buy upgrades.
That's right, Fist Place is actually Cora's Den. I remember now. Quick save.
Looks like it shut down.
Fist knows we're coming.
Take cover!
Locked and loaded.
Get out of the way, Garrus. Let's put up our barrier. Oh, we'll use our shield boost. Get our shield back up.
Locked and loaded. Locked and loaded. Hold the line! Locked and loaded. I'm on it!
Negative contacts.
Stop right there! Don't come any closer!
Warehouse workers. All the real guards must be dead.
Stay back or we'll shoot!
I just killed 50 bodyguards to get in here. What do you think I'll do to you?
Screw Fist. He doesn't pay us enough for this.
It would have been quicker to just kill them.
Shooting people isn't always the answer.
No, but it's fun. This stuff. Quick save.
Why do I have to do everything myself? Time to die.
Shield down.
Wait! Don't kill me! I surrender!
Where's the Quarian?
She's not here. I don't know where she is. That's the truth.
He's no use to you now. Let me kill him.
Wait. I don't know where the Quarian is, but I know where you can find her. The Quarian isn't here. Said she'd only deal with the Shadow Broker himself.
Face to face? Impossible. Even I was hired through an agent.
Nobody meets the Shadow Broker. Ever. Even I don't know his true identity. But she didn't know that. I told her I'd set a meeting up. But when she shows up, it'll be Saren's men waiting for her.
Give me the location. Now.
Here on the wards, the back alley by the markets. She's supposed to meet them right now. You can make it if you hurry.
Boom.
What are you doing?
The Shadow Broker paid me to kill him. I don't leave jobs half done.
I am in charge here. You ever pull another stunt like that?
It was the only contract I had left. And don't we have something more pressing to worry about?
That Quarian's dead if we don't go now.
All right. First, we gotta come through here. Come on. There we go. Where are you? Go.
Anything you want, you can find for sale in the wards.
legal or otherwise.
Just had to make sure to get our discs, and then we gotta fight our way out here. Let's put that on our bar so we can monitor it as well.
Enemy is everywhere!
Garrus is wounded.
All targets down.
So we'll heal him up here now. We're gonna have to head back to Dr. Michelle and get some more Metagel in a second.
Where's the Shadow Broker? Where's Fist?
They'll be here. Where's the evidence?
No way. The deal's off.
Get him, Tally.
Cover.
Oh, God. Come on. Shoot him, boys.
Shield down.
Shield disabled.
Fist set me up. I knew I couldn't trust.
Don't worry about Fist. He got what was coming to him.
Then I guess there are two things I need to thank you for. Who are you?
My name's Shepard. I'm looking for evidence to prove Saren's a traitor.
Then I have a chance to repay you for saving my life. But not here. We need to go somewhere safe.
We could take her to the Human Embassy. Your ambassador will want to see this anyway.
You're not making my life easy, Shepard. Firefights in the wards, an all-out assault on Korra's den. Do you know how many... Who's this? A Quarian? What are you up to, Shepard?
This Quarian can help us bring down Saren. I would have told you that if you hadn't jumped down.
I apologize, Commander. This whole thing with Saren has me a bit on edge. Maybe we should just start at the beginning, Miss...
My name is Tali. Tali Zora Naraya.
We don't see many Quarians here. Why did you leave the flotilla?
I was on my pilgrimage. My rite of passage into adulthood.
I've never heard of this before.
It is a tradition among my people. When we reach maturity, we leave the ships of our parents and our people behind. Alone, we search the stars, only returning to the flotilla once we have discovered something of value. In this way, we prove ourselves worthy of adulthood.
What kinds of things do you look for?
It could be resources like food or fuel, or some type of useful technology, or even knowledge that will make life easier on the flotilla. Through our pilgrimage, we prove that we will contribute to the community, rather than being a burden on our limited resources.
Tell us what you found.
During my travels, I began hearing reports of Geth. Since they drove my people into exile, the Geth have never ventured beyond the Vale. I was curious. I tracked a patrol of Geth to an uncharted world. I waited for one to become separated from its unit. Then I disabled it and removed its memory core.
I thought the Geth fried their memory cores when they died. Some kind of defense mechanism.
How did you manage to preserve the memory core?
My people created the Geth. If you're quick, careful, and lucky, small caches of data can sometimes be saved. Most of the core was wiped clean, but I salvaged something from its audio banks.
Eden Prime was a major victory. Beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
That's Saren's voice. This proves he was involved in the attack.
He said Eden Prime brought him one step closer to finding the conduit. Any idea what that means?
The conduit must have something to do with the beacon. Maybe it's some kind of Prothean technology. Like a weapon.
Wait, there's more. Saren wasn't working alone.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
I don't recognize that other voice, the one talking about Reapers.
I feel like I've heard that name before.
According to the Memory Core, the Reapers were a hyper-advanced machine race that existed 50,000 years ago. The Reapers hunted the Protheans to total extinction, and then they vanished. At least, that's what the Geth believe.
Sounds a little far-fetched.
The vision on Eden Prime. I understand it now. I saw the Protheans being wiped out by the Reapers.
The Geth revere the Reapers as gods, the pinnacle of non-organic life. And they believe Saren knows how to bring the Reapers back.
The Council is just going to love this.
They won't believe you anyway. Just keep them out of this.
We have to tell them. Even if they don't believe anything else, this proves Saren is a traitor.
The Captain's right. We need to present this to the Council right away.
What about her, the Quarian?
My name is Tali. You saw me in the alley, Commander. You know what I can do. Let me come with you.
I thought you were on your...
The pilgrimage proves we are willing to give of ourselves for the greater good. What does it say about me if I turn my back on this? Saren is a danger to the entire galaxy. My pilgrimage can wait.
I'll take all the help I can get.
Thanks. You won't regret this.
Anderson and I will go ahead to get things ready with the Council. Take a few minutes to collect yourself, then meet us in the tower.
Ah, Tali. One of my favorite characters. We want Tali. She's our tech genius. And Garrus, since we're going to go talk to them. They've got all the evidence of stuff. Alright, so Tali needs leveling. Shotguns too. We'll do that later. This gets more snot rifles. Pistols. One more. Apparently, we got some equipment. Good. Tali gets a shotgun. She can have one of those. Accuracy. Yeah, we'll leave it at that. All right.
Excuse me, Commander Shepard. Could you spare a moment? Commander Shepard, my name is Samesh Bhatia. Forgive the intrusion, but I have nowhere else to turn.
A lot of people want my help these days. What makes you special?
My wife was a Marine. She was in the 212 on Eden Prime. I've requested that my wife's body be returned to me for cremation, but the military has refused my request.
Why did they refuse your request? There's got to be some reason.
I don't know. All I know is that they have declared it impossible for my wife to be returned to me.
We'll look into it.
The man in charge of my case is Mr. Bosker. When I last saw him, he was in the expensive bar over there. Thank you for your time. I just want to give my wife a proper funeral and the respect she deserves.
It's a simple side quest. We'll do it real quick since it's right here. That's Executive Palin Suite. Hey, there's Mr. Bosker.
My goodness, you're Commander Shepard. Your activities made for quite a briefing in the Diplomatic Corps. Is there something I can do to assist you?
Yes. A man named Samesh Bhatia is having some trouble claiming his wife's body.
Ah, Mr. Bhatia. A good man in an understandably frustrating position. I wish I could help him. Serviceman Nirali Bhatia died on Eden Prime, as Mr. Bhatia no doubt told you. Her wounds are inconsistent with any type of weapon damage we've seen before. That is why her body is being held.
You think that her body might be dangerous or contaminated?
No, Commander. Nirali Bhatia is not dangerous. Her body is in fact extremely valuable to the Alliance. The tests we're conducting may lead to better defenses against Geth attacks. Respectfully, Serviceman Bhatia may save more lives in death than she did in life.
Yeah.
You know who and what I am. If I want Nirali Bhatia, I can get her.
Commander, I don't think threats are necessary. Even if the body were here on the Citadel, would you really risk going in shooting to get it?
The Marine's name was Nirali Bhatia. If you want to cut her up, you call her by name.
All right, Commander. You win. It was hard enough refusing Mr. Bhatia. I'm not going to risk an incident by refusing you. Tell Samesh that the body is being shipped back to Earth. I'll go now to see to it myself.
Yeah, you do that. I think if you go through some additional dialogue and actually let him keep the body, it has a super minor something in Mass Effect 3 sometime later.
Don't believe the rumors. The consort would never reveal her secrets.
Of course she wouldn't. She'd be tossed out the nearest airlock if she did.
I suppose.
Besides, Nick, the consort's nothing like the girls back on the colonies. She's...
You don't have to do it with her. You can just talk to her if you want.
Is that all you did, Jazz? Just talk?
I didn't say that.
Ha! I bet you did too.
Shut up, Fredericks.
Oh, Commander. Is there something I can do for you?
What can you tell me about the Asari consort?
Well, she's an Asari who works here as... That is, she helps people with things.
You never went to see her, did you?
No, I never did. I couldn't afford it. It costs half a year's credits just to go in and talk to her.
Can you at least tell me where I can find her?
Sure. She's across the bridge from the embassies.
We'll go see her later. I think there's one simple thing to do right back over here. Yep, keeper. We're off. I think there's something in Palin's office. Real quick. Hey, buddy, I'm just going to snoop around your office real quick. Here it is. So we pick up Omnigel. Like, for stuff, it's just an all-purpose whatever thing. You can use it to repair some things later. You can use it to bypass this stupid game thing. In the later games, you'll end up with a ton of it. In the early game, it's kind of hard to come by. Like, we've only just now amassed 20. Just gonna... Diplomatic advisory warning. The following message was transmitted from an untraceable account to multiple recipients across the extranet. Further monitoring of the situation is warranted. My fellow Biotic, you have been selected to receive this transmission because of our shared plight. Few understand us. Fewer tolerate us. We must stand together. We must build our own new world. Come, join us in the Hawking Ada Cluster. Only as one body can we right the wrongs done to our kind. So that's another side mission that we just picked up. Go check out some Biotic extremists. Hey, Tali. And we might do that later. Go tell Mr. Bhatia that he's getting his wife's body back.
Hello again, Commander. Has there been any word?
Your wife is coming home, Mr. Bhatia.
Thank you. I will return home and begin my preparations. It does not bring me happiness, but it may bring me peace. Goodbye, Commander.
Yay, level up. Citadel Tower. A little quest marker back here. Oh, this way, that's right.
Come on. Udine is presenting the Quarian's evidence to the Council.
Her name is Tali.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There are...
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
Who is she?
Matriarchs are powerful Asari who have entered the final stage of their lives. Revered for their wisdom and experience, they serve as guides and mentors to my people. Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
I tried to warn you about Saren and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your...
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
I can take Saren down.
The Commander's right. There is a way to stop Saren that doesn't require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
I faced Saren on Eden Prime and exposed him for a traitor. I've proven...
Commander Shepard, step forward.
Shit.
It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
Any idea where to find him?
We will forward any relevant files to Ambassador Udina.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now. You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
I thought the Ambassador would be a little more grateful. He didn't even thank you.
What do you expect from a politician? Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
Yeah, Spectre training. Alright, so now we are fully fledged and operational Spectres. Let's see if Kahoku has his thing yet. This guy gives out a mission. I'm waiting to speak. There we go.
Congratulations on becoming the first human Spectre, Commander. I'm certain you'll be up to the challenge.
I appreciate that.
My name is Admiral Kahoku. It's about time the Alliance got one of our own in with the Spectres. We need people like you to deal with our problems.
Something wrong, Admiral?
I'm getting stonewalled by bureaucratic assholes. Nothing new. Maybe you can help me, Shepard. One of my recon teams was investigating some strange activity out in the Traverse. Lost contact yesterday. Now I can't get clearance to check it out. Suddenly it's a restricted area. But that doesn't apply to you, Shepard. Spectres can go anywhere they want. You could find out why my team dropped out of contact.
I'll find them, Admiral.
I appreciate that, Commander. I was running out of options. I'm gonna stay here and see if I can find anything out through official channels. Won't hold my breath, though. I'll upload the info on where my team was last seen to your ships. Maybe you can get some answers.
But I don't have a ship yet, Mr. Kahoku.
No, I just want to ask a couple of questions.
Oh, I think we head back to the embassy.
Allow me to be your guide.
Maybe no. Then that means that we head to CSEC. There's a ton more stuff to do around here. There's a lot of side missions. I don't know if I want to do them right now.
Allow me to be your guide.
And some of them are pretty boring. It's just running around the Presidium here, or the wards and stuff like that. So I don't know if I'll show that just yet. But first things first, let's go get us a ship. We get to go down here and requisition some special Spectre stuff.
One sec, looking you up. Commander Shepard, here with the Alliance military. First time on the Citadel, that about right?
How did you know all that?
I'm the CSEC requisitions officer. I need to make sure our buyers are authorized. So, will you be purchasing anything today, Commander Shepard?
Show me what you got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Well, this must be a mistake. System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre? Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
Just show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
Alright, so the rare stocks are these guys right here. The HMWSR Spectre gear, which is some of the best stuff in business, but it costs a ton. We've got 3,000 credits, and that's 147,000 credits. But they've also got some higher-end stuff. We want that. Did I buy that? I think I bought something extra that I didn't need. Buy any of that. Want to sell stuff that's duplicates. Make us a little bit more stuff. So we bought a grenade upgrade, which allows us to carry more grenades, and we bought a license to be able for our shipboard sales guy to offer us some more stock. We'll find those at some of the other vendors throughout the galaxy.
In other news, Exogeni Corp is still denying reports that one of their survey teams has gone missing in the Hades Gamma Cluster. When asked why communication with the survey team was suddenly cut off last week, company officials refused to comment.
And we just picked up another side mission, just overhearing, you know, stuff going on in the elevator. Hello, boys.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
I want the truth. Why are you stepping down, sir?
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
Why didn't you ever mention this?
What was I supposed to say? I could have been a Spectre, but I blew it? I failed, Commander. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
Saren's not gonna get away this time.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the conduit is before he does.
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
Anything else?
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording. She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau cluster.
Sounds like we should head for the Artemis Tau cluster.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll do whatever it takes to stop Saren.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Yes, Commander?
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing, but you're the one who can stop Saren. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
Tell me what happened with you and Saren 20 years ago.
It's close to 20 years ago now. Ambassador Goyle was our representative here on the Citadel. Like Udina, she wanted to get a human into the Spectres. She chose me. The Council sent Saren to keep an eye on me and evaluate my performance, just like they sent Nihlus to keep tabs on you.
I think I deserve the whole story.
We had intel on a rogue scientist being funded by Batarian interests. He was trying to set up a facility to develop illegal AI technology out in the Verge. Alliance intel had done all the work, but the Council wanted a Spectre involved. We compromised. I was assigned to help Saren in his investigation. We tracked the scientist to a refining facility on Kamala. He was hidden away somewhere inside, protected by an army of Batarian mercenaries. The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant, capture the scientist, sneak back out. Quick, quiet, and a minimum of bloodshed.
I'm guessing things didn't go as planned?
Saren and I split up to cover more ground. Then about halfway through the mission, there was a massive explosion in the refinery core. Officially, it was ruled an accident, but I think Saren detonated it on purpose to draw off the enemy guards.
Sounds like overkill to me.
The explosion tore the refinery to shreds. The whole place was on fire. Black chemical clouds poured out into the atmosphere. Nobody inside survived. There was a camp for the workers and their families nearby. Between the fires and the toxic fumes, the final death count was over 500. Mostly civilians. Saren didn't care. The target was eliminated. Mission accomplished. And I ended up taking the blame. That ended all talk of me joining the Spectres.
Saren caused the explosion. How'd he pin it on you?
In his report, Saren accused me of blowing his cover. He said it was my fault the guards were ready for us. He claimed that's why it turned into a massacre. Saren's report was all the proof the Council needed to kill my chances of becoming a Spectre.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? Me? Or their best agent? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. I blame Saren. I think he wanted things to go bad. He was looking for an excuse to blow that refinery. Maybe he just likes the violence. Maybe he was just trying to make me look bad to keep humans out of the Spectres. If so, he pulled it off.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start.
The only thing I care about is stopping Saren.
You're right, Commander. It's no good living in the past.
I want to know the truth about you and Saren.
We had in... The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant...
The only thing I care
You're
about
right,
is
Commander.
Stop...
You're right, Commander. It's no good living in the past.
What do you know about the Artemis Tau cluster?
Not much. I've never been there myself. A handful of systems with a few small, uncharted worlds, but no real colony. Might not be easy finding Dr. Tassoni out there. My advice is to look for the world with the Prothean ruins.
What can you tell me about Novaria?
Novaria's trouble. Always has been. The whole planet's basically a center for corporations to conduct illegal research. Watch your back there, Shepard. Spectres are about the only form of Citadel authority Novaria respects. But they aren't popular.
Any extra intel you can give me on our colony at Pharos?
The entire planet used to be one giant Prothean city. Mostly ruins now. But some of the infrastructure is still intact. The colony tried to build on what the Protheans left behind. We lost all contact with them when the Geth attacked.
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Huh. The
Normandy combines the best of Alliance technology and Turian engineering. It shows what we're capable of if we work.
Where's it? Do the thing. There we go. Right. Yo. New home.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
Heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
The captain got screwed, but it's not like you could have stopped it. Nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander, 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
This began with an attack on a human settlement in the Traverse.
But we know Saren won't stop there. His Geth armies aren't going to stay on the far fringes of Citadel space.
Our enemy knows we're coming.
Wherever he searches for the conduit, we'll be there. We will hunt him to the very ends of the galaxy and bring him down.
This is the most important mission any of us have ever been.
The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
Fancy speeches won't stop Saren from finding the conduit. If we really want to make the captain proud, we better get this bird in the air.
Yes, ma'am.
I think Joker has some conversation for us. Joker, as played by Seth Green, by the way.
Commander, something you need?
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they said she'd be?
She's the best ship in the fleet. If you've got a pilot who knows how to handle her. Balance isn't what you'd expect. Takes a while to get used to that oversized drive core we got stuffed in the back, and her power can sneak up on you if you're not careful. The Normandy's probably too much ship for your average Alliance pilot, Commander. Lucky for you, I'm anything but average.
I'd like to know my crew. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
I can see where this is going. You did a background check on me, didn't you? Well, I'll tell you the same thing I told the captain. You want me as your pilot. I'm not good. I'm not even great. I am the best damn helmsman in the Alliance fleet. Top of my class in flight school, I earned that. All those commendations in my file, I earned every single one. Those weren't given to me as charity for my disease.
What are you talking about? Are you sick?
You mean you didn't know? Oh, crap. Okay, I've got Vrolik syndrome, brittle bone disease. The bones in my legs never develop properly. They're basically hollow, too much force, and they'll shatter. Even with crutches and my leg braces, it's hard to get around. One wrong step and crack! It's very dramatic. But I've learned to manage my condition, Commander. Put the Normandy in my hands and I'll make her dance for you. Just don't ask me to get up and dance, unless, you know, you like the sound of snapping shin bones.
Why does everyone call you Joker?
It's a lot shorter than saying Alliance Flight Lieutenant Jeff Moreau. Plus, I love to make little children laugh.
I was just thinking how much you remind me of Santa Claus.
Look, I didn't pick the name. One of the instructors in flight school used to bug me about never smiling. She started calling me Joker, and it stuck.
Why didn't you ever smile?
Hey, I worked my ass off in flight school, Commander. The world's not gonna hand you anything if you go around grinning like an idiot. By the end of the year, I was the best pilot in the academy. Even better than the instructors, and everybody knew it. They'd all got their asses kicked by the sickly kid with the creaky little legs. One guess who was smiling at graduation?
I have to go.
All right, see you.
I love Joker. He's great. Alright, I think there's some more conversation for us somewhere. Presley got something? Nope. Okay. Yeah, what's over here? Oh, this is the way down. Later. I think we get some more conversations from some people. Lounge. Come on. Caden should be here. Yeah, there he is.
Anything? Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. We'll have time for personal debriefings later.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
I don't see how we could have done things any better. At least not without getting to Eden Prime sooner. And we were on the scene faster than any other Alliance ship could have been.
Talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
So, sort of, but not really. So I don't think anybody else is going to have any more conversation. Guess we'll just head out. Here we come to our galaxy map. Tells us where we get to go. Along with all kinds of fun information about all the places. So we zoom out. And again. Out again. And there's the galaxy. Alright, so we want to go to... So these are all places that we can go. Some of them will have like missions and stuff that we've heard about. Like we heard about something in the Hawking Ada cluster, Kepler Verge, I believe. More things will open up later on, and some of these might even close down. Earth and her solar system. Here? No, that's not open to us yet. Because we should be down here somewhere. We're going to head here to get where they are. Here? Now we get to debark from the station. Some fun stuff to scan around. Like if you go to a planet, get some information about it. And if there's nothing to do about it, there'll be nothing there. Some of them can actually scan. So like you can survey it and you can discover something like, you know, this one has a gas deposit. And those are like side mission things, like a little collectible thing. If you go and scan planets for stuff, you can find, like this one's a gas deposit. It's just getting you to click on things and look at them. They really went all out to give you all kinds of information about all the planets that they created for this. So this one recovered a Turian insignia. Recounting found nothing of interest, but much of the debris was marked with the Magna Colony insignia. So we need to... Let's actually read the journal. Read the journal. So, like, the Turian insignias. It's just a little collectible thing that you can find. Minerals. By scanning planets, you can get light metals, heavy metals, rare earths, and gases. You can also find some of these down on... mark all those for you. Down on the planets. And they will actually give you some bonuses, like if you complete both of these, and I think there's a third one somewhere. They'll give you some slight bonus, starting bonuses in the next game. So it's worth completing at some point. We want to go... So assignments are like the side missions. So we can scan the keepers. We got 13 of 21 so far. That's pretty good. And then missions are all the story stuff. So, okay. So find Liara Tassoni in the Artemis Tau cluster. Not going to tell us anything more than that. We are going to have to, like, search around. So we did that one. Here. Love this loading screen. And there are stuff to find in the asteroid belts like this. So you can find like an asteroid, survey it, get a heavy metal. I believe you can find some other stuff as well. Ah, we found it. Therum, a distant but rich industrial world claimed by the Human Systems Alliance. Its plentiful heavy materials have fueled the recent manufacturing boom on Earth. Core samples rich in the fossils of simple silicon-based organisms indicate Therum was more habitable in the past than it is in the present. Perhaps this explains the many Prothean ruins dotting the surface, most of which have been looted by mining corporations. So, you know, I like that it gives, you know, if there's a colony on there, when it was founded, its population, an orbital period, how long it takes to rotate around the sun, is equivalent of 6.4 Earth years. So every 1 year they experience on Earth, it takes them 6 years to experience the same thing over here. It's radius from the core to this thing. Day length is approximately 28 hours. It's way less atmospheric pressure. Surface temperature 59 Celsius, so it's pretty warm. And it's slightly higher than normal gravity. And that's all the kind of stuff that you'll find in all the other ones. So we're actually going to land... And we want Tali and Rex. Here's our Mako. Probably one of the most hated things about this game.
Commander, I'm picking up some strange readings. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
Alright, so, Mako fires a weapon, got a heavy cannon, and it drives like the worst thing ever. Just like this. Oh my god, I hate this thing. Because, instead of like pushing forward and then using A and D to turn while you're going. Nope, you press A, it just starts driving to the left. Or they did change it. So you can hold A and just turn in a circle. So it's kind of awful. Supposedly this is one of the big things that they're fixing in Andromeda. Because they want to bring back the Mako for like planetary exploration and stuff. But everybody hates the Mako. Like, absolutely despises it. Nothing over there. How we go up here? In Mass Effect 2, I believe, there was a set of missions where you're driving a little hover thingy called the Hammerhead. And that one made a ton of sense. Like, the controls on that were actually really awesome. So those were a lot of fun. Then we're going to drive around here real quick. Like we're on the right path, we're getting some geth drops. And there's some more up ahead. Gotta watch out for those missiles. One more over here. I think that's actually behind the gate.
Only a fool punches a Nathak in the mouth. We should sneak around and pull its tail.
Come on, flip over. There you go. So he's telling us to go this way. You can go forward. This way is actually a little bit easier. You just have to do some weird driving. But then you get to shoot people with the... So we got most of them. Just get rid of that so that doesn't hurt us. Apparently we took a lot of damage. Our shield's super slowly repaired. So like down in the lower left, you'll see our health bars as well as a Mako. And then bars around it are the shields for the Mako. And then the actual Mako itself will show you if there's any physical damage on it. So here.
Cover me.
Heal up Rex. Put on our barrier. Hit him with a warp. I don't hit him with a throw. You hit him with a warp. You can overload him. And we can just wreck his face. All that stuff. Level up. This is going to open the gates out in the front. Oh, Rex wasn't even with us. Bastard's still hanging out by the car. I believe there's some stuff on the other side here. Upgrade kit, some upgrades. I'll take all of that. Grab an extra grenade. We're up to 6 now. And then we go get back in our car. I believe we can snipe this guy from here. Yep. The other one was in a position that we could hit with that cannon. I've tried. Take all that. That gate, which is probably... Oh, okay, there's nothing on the other side. Thought there might have been, like, some turrets or something. Oh my god, Rex, heal yourself up. Wasting all my metagel on your fat ass. Just checking for more crates. So, I'm kind of bothered by the fact that you have a Krogan on our team right here. Krogan are extremely, extremely durable, hardy characters, like lore-wise. They've got, you know, four hearts, multiple sets of all kinds of organs, and that big hump on their back is just full of nutrients and shit. And Krogan that you fight in the game have a natural regeneration ability. Makes fighting them really hard. But Rex doesn't. He's a Krogan like all the rest. Why doesn't he have regen, heal up his health like all the others? Oh, there they are. Keep moving so their stuff doesn't hit us. Oop. Just drove ourselves into the lava. That would have been no bad. Or no good. No bueno. That guy just kind of hanging out there.
Think we got him, Commander.
I don't know. That guy's looking awfully shady just hanging out there. Oh, we can't even see him anymore. That's a bummer. I wanted to get closer and see if I get a screen grab, but... I don't miss this. You want action, Taylor? We got plenty of action coming up. You can just hold your horses. Remember to quick save. Those are some great barricades there, boys. Yep. Now we go on foot. Get over here. Can we get a better gun? Do we have armor piercing? Yes. Rex. Shotgun. F. That. Some stability. Holly. Piercing 1. Heavy armor piercing 2. Well, damage 2 is good. For ours, yeah, that's fine. Oh, we got snipers. And that's why we did the quick save right before that.
Kill them all.
Yeah. People up there that we can't get to just yet.
Perimeter secured.
Just yet, it's not, big boy. Lens flare. Save again. Yes, spider monkeys. And a tank. All right. I had to duck behind some stuff and instantly get shot. Guess we can't skip this. Alright, as soon as we can, we're gonna pop our barrier so we don't get insta-sniped and see if we can't take out some of them snipers. Here. Circle around. We want to take out all the foot soldiers before we engage this armature. Where are we? Come on. There's one more. All right. So aim. We'll select warp. Tyler's blocked from hitting it. She can overload it. Have you warp it as well? Barrier. And get insta-killed again. The problems of the Adept. You're a space wizard who's weak in the early game, but ridiculously overpowered in late game. And that's basically, you know, a tank that we're fighting on foot with a pea shooter. This is actually the hardest part of this mission. What else we got? We do. You've already used all your stuff. So. Let's try a grenade here in a second. Sabotage, get rid of that. I'm gonna pop barrier again. Oh, I forgot to put that on there. So we'll do that, and that'll give us some bunch of free shots. Oh, we're overheated. Hey, there we go. Quick save. What? There we go. Okie dokie. I don't think there's any boxes around here. We'll heal up though. And head on in. Ooh, jeez. That. You guys are a lot of help, let me tell you.
Perimeter secured.
We need somebody with first aid skills. I don't think either of these people does it. Squad. Nope. You can get first aid, you just don't have it yet. So, can we? That. Yay, first aid. Rex, who's got 10? Carnage, get some extra damage. Get you some fitness, get you some extra health. The tank. Unity to res everybody. Awesome. Oh, and we got Adept too. Biotic resistance reduces recharge time. Hell yeah, I want to get some of that stuff. I'll look at our equipment later.
It looks like this cavern formed around the ruin after it was built.
We gotta take this down here. Our weapons at the ready. Except for in the elevator. Because they're dangerous in elevators. And elevator number 2. Uh-oh. I think we're taking that one back up.
Hello? Could somebody help me?
hear me out there? I'm trapped. I need help.
The Aratisoni, I presume?
Thank the goddess. I did not think anyone would come looking for me. Listen, this thing I'm in is a Prothean security device. I cannot move, so I need you to get me out of it, all right?
How did you end up in there?
I was exploring the ruins when the Geth showed up, so I hid in here. Can you believe that? Geth beyond the veil! I activated the tower's defenses. I knew the barrier curtains would keep them out. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please!
Your mother is working with Saren. Whose side are you on?
What? I am not on anybody's side. I may be Benezia's daughter, but I'm nothing like her. I have not spoken to her in years. Please, just get me out of here.
Some kind of propulsion field in the way.
It's a Prothean barrier curtain. I knew it would keep me safe from the Geth. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please.
Any suggestions on how we can help?
There is a control in here that should deactivate this thing. You'll have to find some way past the barrier curtain. That's the tricky part. The defenses cannot be shut off from the outside. I don't know how you'll get in here. Be careful. There is a Krogan with the Geth. They have been trying different ways to get past the barrier. Oh, how did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
We blasted through with the mining laser.
Of course. Yes, that makes sense. Please, get me out of here before more Geth arrive. That button over there should shut down this containment field.
Any idea how we get out of this place?
There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator.
It should take us out of here. Come on! I still cannot believe all this. Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Seren's looking for the conduit. You're a Prothean expert. He probably wants you to help him find it.
The conduit? But I don't know...
What the hell was that?
These ruins are not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister!
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
He needs to move faster.
If I die in here, I'll kill him.
Hey, how did you get in? How'd you get past that barrier?
Surrender! Or don't. That would be...
There a reason you're in my way?
Same reason you're here. The Asari. Thanks for getting rid of those energy fields for us. Hand the doctor over.
Whatever it is you want, you are not getting it from me.
Is this really the time?
The atmosphere is perfect for a life and death struggle. Kill him. Spare the Asari if you can. If not, doesn't matter.
They're going left. Get rid of him. I'm gonna circle around. Out of the way. Fuck. I forgot that you have to use Unity to res them. I'll get it back.
I still cannot believe
Seren's looking for the conduit, but
yep, skip.
We have to hurry.
Joker, get the note.
He needs.
Yeah. Alright, come on. Hurry up. Swag around past those barriers before they come up again.
Surrender. Or don't. That would be more fun.
Just kill this bastard.
We don't have time to deal with this idiot. Charge!
I like your attitude.
Alright. We need to put the R bar. How do we want to do this? Sniper is getting warp. That shock trooper is getting bracket trooper. Trooper is getting. Drop our barrier and swing around this way. Maybe. If we don't get caught on a Rex. Shit. That. And get out of the way. Jeez, it's like right on top of me. Krogans are like no joke. I legitimately have trouble against them every time.
I still cannot.
Seren's looking for
the conduit.
What the hell?
Joker.
Because they have that charge ability, when they start getting close, they close the distance. They use shotguns, which do massive damage up close. They regen. Like the Geth, I don't have any problems with. It's just the Krogan.
Surrender. Or don't. That would be more fun.
Whatever, just kill
him. We don't have time to deal.
Alright, so let's try this again. Get rid of that sniper. That's... sabotage his weapons. Warp that guy. There we go. I think we're warped. All right, where is this dude? Okay. AI hacking doesn't do anything. That's... our warp is used. Let's try and throw him. Pop this. There he goes. Jesus, that's loud all of a sudden.
Too close, Commander. 10 more seconds, we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
We almost died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
Joker pulled our asses out of there. I think he's earned the right to a few bad jokes.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander. But I am grateful to you. You saved my life back there, and not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
Just how old are you exactly?
I hate to admit it, but I am only 106.
Damn! I hope I look that good when I'm your age.
A century may seem like a long time to a short-lived species like yours, but among the Asari, I am barely considered more than a child. That is why my research has not received the attention it deserves. Because of my youth, other Asari scholars tend to dismiss my theories on what happened to the Protheans.
I've got my own theory on why the Protheans disappeared.
With all due respect, Commander, I have heard every theory out there. The problem is finding evidence to support them. The Protheans left remarkably little behind. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved. It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge. Patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right, and eventually I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
What cycle? What are you talking about?
The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the Citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
They were wiped out by a race of sentient machines, the Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it...
Visions? Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear. I am amazed you were able to make sense of it at all. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process. You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
This isn't helping us find Saren, or the Conduit.
Of course, you're right. I am sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the Conduit, or Saren.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Good to have you on the team, Liara.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful. Oh, I am afraid I am feeling a bit lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion, coupled with the shock of discovering the Protheans' true fate. I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
We've received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
Liara's on our side. The Geth were trying to kill her.
Benezia would never allow Saren to kill her daughter.
Maybe she doesn't know.
Or maybe we don't know her. We never expected she could become a traitor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
Yes. Yes, we're all counting on you, Commander Shepard. And I think that's where we're going to end it for tonight. I really look forward to completing the series in the coming weeks. Yes, weeks, because there's three games to get through, and they're each one is bigger than the last. But it's going to be a fun time. And I want to thank you guys in advance for showing up for each of these and watching this whole thing through. Hopefully you've got the sound issue sorted out now that I'm using the proper OBS. But I'll continue working on OBS Studio. I think I like that a little bit better. But we'll stick with this for now. Anyway, if you guys watch it tonight, thanks for showing up. If you watch it on VOD, you know, thanks for watching. Hit that like button. Hit the share button. Share it with your friends. Get other people in here. Share the glory that is Mass Effect with them. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and then the little notification button to get notified whenever I go live. And leave a comment. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys want to be here to help me make some of the decisions in some of the later games, or even in this one, we can help shape this together. Until then, I will see you guys next time. Thanks for stopping by.